Hello students, we are going to discuss about types of chemical reactions, and I have selected the PDF of your chapter, and from that only I am going to explain to you what are types of chemical reactions. Types of chemical reactions. So the first type of chemical reaction, which I told you about last week only, that is combination reaction. What is a combination reaction? You can see that in a combination reaction, two or more reactants combine together to form a single product. You are having just one product over here. In this you see calcium oxide and water combine to form a single product. So single product is formed, and this indicates the combination reaction is taking place. So any reaction in which two or more reactants combine to form one product are known as combination reactions. So another examples which are given in your book are burning of coal is also an example of combination reaction. So in this you can see that carbon reacts with oxygen gas to form carbon dioxide. Now formation of water is also a combination reaction. Formation of water from hydrogen and oxygen is also a combination reaction. How? Because two volumes of hydrogen will react with one volume of oxygen to form two volumes of water. So in simple language we can see that when two or more substances combine to form a single product, the reaction is called as a combination reaction. So let us see some other examples of the reactions, and we will see that whether they are a combination reaction or not. So one example of a reaction is given here as burning of natural gas. Natural gas is mainly composed of methane. So when methane burns in oxygen, it produces carbon dioxide and water vapor. So can you say that this reaction is a combination reaction? No, this reaction is not a combination reaction, because two reactants are combining to form two products here. So since two products are formed, so the given reaction of burning of natural gas is not a combination reaction. But can it be another type of reaction? Yes, you know that when natural gas burns, it will produce, along with carbon dioxide and water vapor, it will also produce heat. So a reaction in which heat is released along with formation of products are known as exothermic chemical reaction. So what is an exothermic chemical reaction? A reaction in which heat is evolved is known as exothermic chemical reaction. See the next one. This is a reaction between glucose and oxygen. So when glucose reacts with oxygen, it forms carbon dioxide, water vapor and energy. So this reaction is also an example of exothermic reaction, and this reaction takes place in our body. It takes place in our body when the digested food is absorbed by the blood and it is carried to each and every cell. In the mitochondria of the cell, this reaction takes place and energy is released from the digested food. So this reaction takes place during respiration of food. Now the decomposition of vegetable matter into compost is also an example of exothermic reaction. So when the food particles are decomposed by microorganism, heat is also released, and that is also an example of exothermic reaction. Another type of reaction, it is decomposition reaction. Decomposition, what is a decomposition reaction? Now you can see we have got a figure in which a girl is performing some experiment. She is having a burner and she is holding a test tube with the help of tongs in her hand. And what is she doing? Let us see that. Some instructions are given over here. the Bohling test tube she is having. And then you have got ferrous sulfate crystals. Some ferrous sulfate crystals are taken and she is heating ferrous sulfate crystals. And then again the vapors, this gas which is evolved, she is taking the smell of the gas. So it's the same reaction is explained over here. You can see that ferrous sulfate. Ferrous sulfate, it is a solid. Upon heating, it breaks up into Fe2O3, which is ferric oxide, sulfur dioxide, and sulfur trioxide. So it is splitting up, or it is breaking up into three substances. So such type of reaction in which a single reactant breaks up into two or more product is known as a decomposition reaction. So in this case you have seen that ferrous sulfate upon heating decomposed into three products, which is ferric oxide, with along with ferric oxide, sulfur dioxide and sulfur trioxide is also formed. So sulfur dioxide has got a smell of burning sulfur, and that is why it was indicated in the picture that the girl was trying to take the smell of the gas which was evolved. Now another example is thermal decomposition of calcium carbonate. So you can see here calcium carbonate is CaCO3, so which is also known as limestone. So limestone, when it is heated, it decomposes into quick lime and carbon dioxide. So this is a decomposition reaction, and the decomposition reaction, when it takes place, see, when a decomposition reaction is carried out by heat, it is known as thermal decomposition. So two reactions you have studied of thermal decomposition, which is thermal decomposition of ferrous sulfate, and second one is thermal decomposition of calcium carbonate. So this calcium carbonate upon heating, it decomposes to give quick lime and carbon dioxide. And you know, how can you test the presence of carbon dioxide? How can you show that calcium carbonate upon heating decomposes to give carbon dioxide? You know that carbon dioxide turns lime water milky, and when you will pass this carbon dioxide, the gas formed through lime water, and if lime water turns milky, it indicates that the gas evolved was carbon dioxide. Let us see the third decomposition reaction, thermal decomposition reaction, which is given in your book. The third thermal decomposition reaction is thermal decomposition of lead nitrate. So lead nitrate in presence of heat, it is decomposing to give lead oxide, nitrogen dioxide gas and oxygen gas. Nitrogen dioxide gas is a brown color gas. So when you will heat lead nitrate, you will observe brown color gas coming out of the test tube, and this indicates that lead nitrate is decomposing to form nitrogen dioxide. So let us see an figure activity over here. In the activity, this activity is demonstrating electrolysis of water. So I'll explain this activity to you. We have taken a plastic mug is taken, two holes are made at the base of the plastic mug through which two metal electrodes are fitted. One of the metal electrode is joined to the negative terminal of the battery, and the electrode joined to the negative terminal of the battery is known as cathode. Another electrode is joined to the positive terminal of the battery and it is known as anode. Now this electrodes here are made up of graphite rod. Graphite is a form of carbon, and graphite rods are taken in this case because they are non-reactive. And acidulated water is taken. Acidulated water is one in which a little amount of sulfuric acid is mixed, and the purpose of adding sulfuric acid to water is to increase the ionization of water. Ionization of water means water splits up into H plus and OH minus ion. So if we will not add sulfuric acid to it, very little ionization of water will take place, and due to which the electrolysis process will not occur properly. So you can see that we have got two inverted test tubes on each electrode, and this will facilitate collection of the gas. So when electricity is passed through acidulated water, then water splits up or decomposes to give hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. So you can see that some bubbles are shown in the test tube. You can see the diagram, there are some bubbles coming out in the test tube, and these bubbles are the gases which are formed at different electrode. Now anode is the positive terminal or the positive electrode, so oxygen formation will take place on anode, and on the cathode, which is negative electrode, hydrogen gas will be formed. So this figure shows electrolysis of water. Electrolysis of water, or what is electrolysis? Decomposition in presence of electric current is known as electrolysis. Now we have got some photolysis. As I said, electrolysis, lysis means breakdown. So breakdown in presence of electricity is known as electrolysis, while breakdown in presence of light is known as photolysis. So now we are going to discuss the example of photolysis. So AgCl, silver chloride, AgCl, in presence of sunlight, it decomposes to give silver and chlorine gas. So this is an example of photolysis. You can see here, white silver chloride turns gray in sunlight. This is due to decomposition of silver chloride into silver by light. So light is breaking silver chloride into silver and chlorine gas. Similar reaction is given over here. Silver bromide also behaves in the same way. So AgBr, silver bromide, AgBr, in presence of sunlight, it breaks up into silver and bromine gas. So these two reactions that we had discussed now, they are used in black and white photography. And what form of energy is causing this decomposition reaction? It is light energy which is causing the decomposition reaction. So in the book, it's the next line says that the decomposition reaction requires energy either in the form of heat, light, or electricity for breaking down the reactants. Now the reaction in which heat is absorbed are known as endothermic reaction, and we had discussed about exothermic reaction in the previous part. So exothermic reactions are those reactions in which heat is evolved, while those reactions in which energy is absorbed is known as endothermic reaction. Now this energy could be in the form of heat, light, electricity, anything, but usually it is in the form of heat. That is why the word endothermic. The next type of reaction is displacement reaction. You have studied about displacement reaction in class 8. There are two types of displacement reaction: single displacement reaction and double displacement reaction. Let us begin our discussion with single displacement reaction. Figure 1.8 in the book, you can see page number 10, you have got figure 1.8. So in this figure, you can see that we have got a stand over here to which a test tube is clamped, and the test tube has got some blue color solution into it, and two iron nails are tipped, are suspended. You can see that two iron nails are suspended in this blue color solution with the help of a thread. So this blue color solution is copper sulfate solution, and copper sulfate is also known as blue vitriol. And when you dip iron nail into this solution and leave it undisturbed for few hours, you will see that this blue color of the solution changes into pale green color. And why this change take place? Because iron is more reactive than copper, so iron will displace copper from its aqueous solution of copper sulfate. So the color change is observed, and such type of reaction in which a more reactive metal displaces a less reactive metal from its aqueous salt solution is known as single displacement reaction. So you can see that how the iron nail taken out from copper sulfate solution, the gray color of iron nail changes into it's a reddish brown color. Why it will change red? Because now the deposition of copper has taken place on the. So there were two observations. The one or first observation was that the solution, the color of the solution changed from blue to pale green, and second observation was that iron nail, the gray color of iron nail changed into reddish brown color because copper was deposited on iron nail. So such type of reaction is known as single displacement reaction. So see here, the following chemical reaction takes place in this activity. So iron Fe, when it reacts with aqueous copper sulfate, it forms ferrous sulfate and copper is deposited. So in this reaction, iron has displaced or removed another element, copper, from copper sulfate, and this reaction is known as displacement reaction. Another examples of displacement reactions are given in your book. Another examples are zinc. When it reacts with copper sulfate, it will form zinc sulfate, and again copper will be deposited. Similarly, lead, when it is reacting with copper chloride, you can see that it will form lead chloride, and again copper deposition takes place. Why both the reactions are possible? Because both zinc and lead are more reactive elements than copper, so they displace copper from its compound. Now the next topic is double displacement reaction. In double displacement reaction, you can see that exchange of ions take place. The exchange of ion could either be in the form of cation or anion. So what are cation? Positively charged ions are known as cation, and negatively charged ions are known as anion. So let us see an example. We have got a figure in which a person is mixing two types of solution. You can see that two types of solutions are mixed into each other. So what will happen? It's mentioned over here that you have one of the test tube is containing barium chloride and another test tube contains sodium sulfate. So let us see what reaction will happen when both the solutions are mixed. So you have sodium sulfate. When sodium sulfate is mixed with aqueous solution of barium chloride, a white color precipitate is formed. White color substance is formed, and that white color substance is barium sulfate along with NaCl. Why this white color substance is formed? Because barium sulfate is insoluble in water. Sodium sulfate is soluble in water. Barium chloride is soluble in water, but barium sulfate formed is insoluble in water and it is white in color. So a white color insoluble substance is formed, and this insoluble substance is known as precipitation. So any reaction that produces a precipitate can be called a precipitation reaction. So a double decomposition reaction can also be said as precipitation reaction if a precipitate is formed. See, the reason is given over here. What causes this? The white precipitate of barium sulfate is formed by reaction of sulfate and barium ion. The other product formed is sodium chloride, which remains in solution. Why it remains in solution is because NaCl is soluble in water. So such reaction in which there is an exchange of ions between reactants are called as double displacement reaction. That's all for today.